This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Andrew Colté Ducarel, the 9th of June 1713 to the 29th of May 1785, was an English antiquary, librarian, and archivist. He was also a lawyer practicing civil law, civilian, and a member of the College of Civilians. Contents 1. Early life and education. 2. Legal and administrative career. 3. Antiquarian, library and archival career. 4. Wider antiquarianism. 5. Character sketches. 6. Death and legacy. 7. Personal life. 8. Works. 9. References. 91 references from DNB. 10. Bibliography. 11. External links. Early life and education. Ducarel was born on 9 June 1713 in Paris. His parents, Jacques Colté Ducarel 1680-1718 and Jean Cromelin 1690-1723, were Huguenots from Normandy. Jacques was a banker and merchant, who achieved ennoblement in 1713 with the title Marquis de Château de Muids. He died in 1718, just as a new wave of Huguenot persecution was beginning, and in 1719 Jean fled with her three infant sons, first to Amsterdam, and then, in 1721, to England. They settled in Greenwich, where Jean married her second husband, Jacques Girardot, another Huguenot. In 1728 Andrew was sent to be educated at Eton. The following year he suffered a serious accident there in which he lost one eye. He spent 3 months under the medical care of Sir Hans Sloane. In 1731 he matriculated at Oxford from Trinity College, but transferred shortly afterwards to St. John's. In 1734, while still undergraduates, he and his brother were naturalized. Ducarel graduated in 1738 as a Bachelor of Civil Law, and then moved to Trinity Hall, Cambridge. He was created Doctor of Civil Law in 1742, and went out a Grand Compounder. On 21 October 1748 he was admitted a member of the College of Advocates at Doctors' Commons. 3 November 1743, and afterwards served as librarian there 1754-7, and as treasurer 1757-61. Legal and administrative career. Ducarel was appointed commissary or official, i.e. an ecclesiastical judge of the Royal Peculiar of St. Catherine's by the Tower by Archbishop Thomas Herring in 1755, of the City and Diocese of Canterbury by Archbishop Thomas Secker in December 1758, and of the sub-deaneries of South Malling, Pagham, and Taring in Sussex, by Archbishop Frederick Cornwallis. On the death of Dr. Dennis Clark, in 1776. In 1756, on the outbreak of the Seven Years' War, he was appointed to the High Court of Admiralty to take depositions for prize ships. Antiquarian, library and archival career. On 22 September 1737 Ducarel was elected a Fellow of the Society of Antiquaries of London, and he was one of the first Fellows of the Society nominated by the President and Council on its incorporation in 1755. He was also elected a member of the Society of Antiquaries at Cortona on 29 August 1760, was admitted a Fellow of the Royal Society of London on 18 February 1762, became an Honorary Fellow of the Society of Antiquaries of Cassel in November 1778, and of the Society of Antiquaries of Scotland in 1781. In 1755 he failed to obtain the post of sub-librarian at the British Museum, but in 1757 he was appointed Keeper of Lambeth Palace Library by Archbishop Hutton. His predecessors in this post, who had included Henry Wharton, Edmund Gibson and David Wilkins, had all been clergymen who treated the post as a part-time responsibility and as a stepping stone to more lucrative ecclesiastical preferments. Ducarel, by contrast, remained in post for nearly 30 years, under five archbishops: Herring, Hutton, Secker, Cornwallis, and more. Until his death he greatly improved the catalogues both of the printed books and the manuscripts at Lambeth, and made a digest, with a general index, of all the registers and records of the province of Canterbury. He was assisted by his friend, Edward Roe Morais, the Rev. Henry Hall, his predecessor in the office of librarian, and the engraver Benjamin Thomas Pouncey, who was for many years his clerk and deputy librarian. Ducarel's contribution was seriously impeded by his complete blindness in one eye, and the weakness of the other. Besides the digest preserved among the official archives at Lambeth, he formed another personal manuscript collection in 48 volumes. volumes. After his death, this passed to the antiquary Richard Gough, and in 1810 was bought for the British Museum Library. He also took a more general interest in the ecclesiastical antiquities of the province of Canterbury, and, with Moray's, compiled a history of Croydon Palace and of the town of Croydon. This was completed and presented to Archbishop Herring in manuscript in 1755, and published in 1783. However, the work led to a virulent rift between the two friends, when Moray's, who had made significant contributions to it, discovered that he was not named on the title page in 1763. Duquerel was appointed by the government, with Sir Joseph Ayloffe and Thomas Astle, to sort and catalogue the records of the State Paper Office at Whitehall, and afterwards those in the Augmentation Office. On the death of Archbishop Secker in 1768, Duquerel applied for the post of secretary to the new archbishop, Frederick Cornwallis, but without success. Wider antiquarianism. For many years, Duquerel used to go in August on an antiquarian tour through different parts of the country, in company with his friend Samuel Gale, and attended by a coachman and footman. They travelled about 15 miles a day, and put up at inns after dinner. While Gale smoked his pipe, Duquerel transcribed his topographical and archaeological notes in an engraving of London Bridge Chapel by George Vertu. The figure measuring is Duquerel, and that standing is Gale in 1752, with a friend, Thomas Bever. He undertook a tour of Normandy through his publications Tour Through Normandy in a Letter to a Friend 1754, later greatly expanded and illustrated as Anglo-Norman Antiquities Considered 1767. He effectively put the duchy on the map for the late 18th century English traveller. He was one of the first Englishmen to see and appreciate the significance of the Bayeux Tapestry, and included an account of it written by his late friend Smart Le Thulier, the first detailed description in English, as an appendix to Anglo-Norman Antiquities Character Sketches. Francis Gross described Duquerel in scathing terms: "The doctor was a very weak man, and ignorant, though he was ambitious of being thought learned. Among the many publications which bear his name, none were really written by him, most of them were done by Sir Joseph Ayloffe, and the Rev. Mr. Morant, author of the History of Essex, to whom the doctor applied on every emergency. He was so very illiterate, that on receiving a Latin letter from a foreign university, he took his chariot, and went down to Colchester, where Mr. Morant then lived, and got him to write an answer." Gross also wrote, "The doctor was a large black man, with only one eye, and that of a focus not exceeding half an inch, so that whatever he wished to see distinctly he was obliged to put close to his nose. Always was a great lover of the ladies as well as his glass. The latter grew on him so much, that he was constantly drunk every day. A little before his death, his liquor was generally port, or as he called it, kill priest." Horace Walpole also formed a negative opinion of him: "Dr. Duquerel was a poor creature. He was keeper of the library at Lambeth, and I wanted a copy of that limning there, which is prefixed to my royal and noble authors. Applying to the doctor, I found nothing but delays. I must purchase his works, and take some of his antiques at an exorbitant price." Religiously observed that, as Duquerel himself often maintained, he was an old Oxonian, and therefore never knew a man till he had drunk a bottle of wine with him. His entertainments were in the true style of the old English hospitality, and he was remarkably happy in assorting the company he not infrequently invited to his table. Death and legacy. Duquerel was a fit and athletic man, who believed that he would live to a great age. The immediate cause of his final illness was the shock of receiving a letter at Canterbury informing him that his wife was at the point of death. He hurried home to South Lambeth, took to his bed, and died 3 days later. On the 29th of May 1785, he was buried on the north side of the altar in the Church of St. Catherine's by the Tower. In the event, Mrs. Duquerel survived him more than 6 years, dying on the 6th of October 1791. His coins, pictures, and antiquities were sold by auction on the 30th of November 1785, and his books, manuscripts, and prints in April 1786. The greater part of the manuscripts passed into the hands of Richard Gough and John Nichols. Personal life. In 1749, Duquerel married Sarah Desborough, 1696-1791. She was a widow 17 years his senior, and had previously been his housekeeper. He is said to have married her out of gratitude, after being nursed by her through a severe illness. In Gross's view, these circumstances tended greatly to his future establishment, Mrs. Duquerel being a sober, careful woman. There were no children of the marriage. Works. A Tour Through Normandy, described in a letter to a friend anon London, 1754, republished in a greatly enlarged form and under Duquerel's name as Anglo-Norman Antiquities Considered, in A Tour Through Part of Normandy, illustrated with 27 copperplates London, 1767. De Registris Lambethanus Dissertationcula London, 1766. A series of above 200 Anglo-Gallic, or Norman and Aquitaine coins of the ancient kings of England London, 1766. 1757 some account of Brown Willis, ESQ, LLD London, 1760 a repertory of the endowments of vicarages in the Diocese of Canterbury London, 1763, 2nd edn, 1782 a letter to William Watson, M.D., upon the early cultivation of botany in England, and some particulars about John Tradescant, gardener to Charles I London, 1773, appeared originally in Philosophical Transactions, Volume 63, p. Some account of the alien priories, and of such lands as they are known to have possessed in England and Wales, collected by John Warburton, Somerset Herald, and Dukerell, 2 vols. London, 1779, 2nd edn 1786 History of the Royal Hospital and Collegiate Church of St. Catherine, near the Tower of London 1782 Some account of the town, church, and archiepiscopal palace of Croydon 1783 written with Edward Roe Mores History and Antiquities of the Archiepiscopal Palace of Lambeth 1785, in Bibliotheca Topographica Britannica, Volume 2 References Carat This specialized form of law was used in certain jurisdictions in England, including the Royal Peculiar of St. Catherine's by the Tower, and in Anglican Ecclesiastical Courts Carat A B C D E F Myers 2008 Carat Jones Baker 1995, p. 330 Carat Du Carrel, Andrew Colty CRL 739 AC A Cambridge Alumni Database University of Cambridge. Carat Nichols 1812, p. 380 Carat Slatter 1957, p. 97 Carat Slatter 1957 Carat Myers 1999, pp. 200-204 Carat Nichols 1812, p. 402 Carat Myers 1996 Carat Gross 1792, p. 140 Carat I.E. Dark and Swarthy Carat Gross 1792, p. 142 Carat Walpole, Horace 1799 Walpoliana 1 London, R. Phillips P. National Biography 16 London, Smith, Elder. Nichols, John Chapter 1812, Dr. Andrew Dukerell Literary Anecdotes of the 18th Century, comprising biographical memoirs of W. Bowyer, and many of his learned friends 6 London, Nichols, Son, and Bentley pp.